Normally, the habs are lit up top to bottom, all the time. A lot of the gear was waterproof. Some of the lights and monitors were still running. So it wasn't dark, but it's fading. Like the whole thing's on life support. Relentless. I mean, the isolation is unnatural. Little problems start to spiral. Any baggage you don't check at the surface comes unpacked pretty quick. Some find ways to cope, others struggle. Watching life go by inside the bubble is cruel. The ones that care get a head start learning to live without you. So the grief comes first, whether or not you're really gone. Thank you. seen death before, but not like this. Up here, the impact's usually more abstract. This is intimate. It's like when you pass an accident on the freeway. All the possibilities run wild. But then a song you like comes on, or your exit's coming up, and you've moved on. Back to normal. They're planning on 60, 75 once the whole thing's staffed up. So with just 20 of us, there's already this hollow quality. Like dropping by the office when everyone's gone for the weekend. Not a lot of time for recreation, but the options were there. They did their best to keep us happy. God we trust, everything else gets triple checked. But so much diligence makes every aspect of daily life heavy. Each task or item, like getting into a suit or going outside, has an equivalent weight. So, for getting cargo or yourself over to Compass 2, the shuttle's the most efficient option, relatively speaking. They kept the heat up, but the weight and presence of the ocean, you can't shake that. Gets under your nails and gums like your teeth are coming loose. At some point, it recedes. You might not notice that till you're topside, but it's always there. Thank you. thought about giving up. With that much time to think about nothing. Just about anyone would. Thing is, the suit's designed to keep you safe, even from yourself. Makes it hard to take the easy way out. Still, does it make it better knowing how bad things really are? The suit keeps out what you need to be afraid of. Only the fear is trapped in there with you, and it's thriving. So yeah, maybe you're safe and dry, but inside you're drowning.
You were prepared, but what happened next caught you completely off guard. Can we talk about that?